So hello everyone, I'm Dr. Rohit Singh Latha, Associate Professor in Mechanical Engineering, the North Cape University. Today I'm here on this platform, particularly the webinar, on which I'll be delivering a talk on the most promising industries for tomorrow's mechanical engineers. So particularly I'll be talking in general about mechanical engineering, what are the options that you have, what are the different kind of job opportunities that you have, what are the professions that you'll get, what are the areas that are available, and an overview about general sectors that are there where you can actually go and join a job and have a good career ahead, and then some part of the design thinking process, or typically the core engineering process through which you have to go through, which is very specific to mechanical engineering. Other fields don't really get the opportunity to have that. So this is going to be unique for mechanical engineers, and then we will have a question answer session in which you can ask about your queries, your questions that you have. So this will be about the talk today. So let me start with the talk now. So if we really talk about mechanical engineering, so mechanical engineering is the second largest profession in the world, right? And it is the most, one of the most oldest discipline, if I talk about, if you really compare it with computer engineering, if you really compare it with electrical engineering. So the typical, if I really talk about the oldness or how, old mechanical engineering is. So it is at least, 200 to 300 years before Christ. So that is the, chronological details or history about mechanical engineering that is available. So it is one of the very old discipline, particularly in engineering. So you might find it both exciting and challenging. So that is great. So the reason being that mechanical engineering has a lot of hands-on stuff that you can do, a lot of things that you can learn, particularly the machine part, a lot of machinery involved, a lot of hands-on work that you can carry out, which is not really, if you really compare with other branches, so that is not that it is not that involving as it is in the case of mechanical engineering. Then the other thing with mechanical engineering is that every industry needs a mechanical engineer, either be it textile industry, either be it mechanical industry, either be it thermal industry, either be it medical industry. So every industry requires a typical mechanical engineer. The curriculum, particularly of mechanical engineering degree, is very vast and it is very versatile. So you will go through different courses through which you will be going, for example, maybe the basic, your basic physics, chemistry, they will study, maths you will study, then there will be management courses as well, then there will be core courses. So to give you an overview, so these are the different kinds of courses that you're going to study. Then you also study about work, forces, motion, materials, energy. So this all is there, which you might have studied in certain amount in your typical, 10th, 11th and 12th. Now it is also very specific to point this thing out that mechanical engineering is concerned with analysis of specific, mechanical related design, then manufacturing, operations, and what are the different areas where it is available. It is in energy, it is in defense, environment, health, biosector, manufacturing and transportation. So mechanical engineering is a very versatile trade, as I have told you right now. So you could really understand the importance and the application of mechanical engineering throughout your day-to-day life as well. So why would you want to be a mechanical engineer? That is the question that should be there in your mind. So one of the very important thing is that you have set high goals in life. So that is one of the important reasons you want to be a mechanical engineer. You want strong you want to get strong college education, which is applicable to most of the areas in day-to-day life. So mechanical engineering gives you that opportunity. You like maths and science and you want to really apply them to the real world problems, which is only possible with mechanical engineering, not really possible with other trades, which often people miss out on. You enjoy hands-on work and tinkering with things, so very important. Mechanical engineering gives you that opportunity. You were told that engineers make a lot of money and mechanical engineers do make a lot of money, so that is there. you were told that you could get a good job with an engineering degree. Yes, mechanical engineering also gives you that platform to have a good job and good career. And also you want to really help humanity, you want to really help people with. So this is one of the essential traits of a mechanical engineer, to help on or work on socially relevant issues and problems. Then in general, if you really talk about mechanical engineering course, so when you really take admission in any mechanical engineering course, so there are two kind of courses that you are offered. Some are core courses, which are fundamental courses of mechanical engineering, where you study typical statistics, you study dynamics, kinematics, mechanics of solid and fluids. Then you have materials, material engineering and processing. Then you have different elective courses related to core. So it can be automobile, it can be design, it can be thermal, industrial, renewable energy is one of the core areas. So that is there. Then you have mechanical systems, where you have vibration control, mechanical electrical systems, you have mechatronics. Then when we really talk about other courses, we have thermodynamics. Now thermodynamics happens to be one of the most applied area. To give you an example, in typically thermodynamics, so we have a concept of entropy. So what does entropy tell you? It tells you about general randomness of things. So this is one concept of mechanical engineering thermodynamics, which is applicable to financial sector, which is applicable to in general life, which is applicable in physics. So this is one of the core areas. Then we have heat transfer, we have internal combustion engines, so specifically related to automotive sector. Then we have refrigeration and air conditioning. So if you go to a mall, you go to a, you know, if you typically go to a PVR, so wherever, so you have the air conditioning system, so that all comes under mechanical engineering, HVAC system we call it. Then we have machines, we have graphics design, machine elements, controls, machine design, FEM. So these are certain areas. Then apart from these things, you are also offered courses in economics, economic engineering, cost analysis, economic analysis. So all these things are there. And then something related to arts as well. So human and social studies, arts, humanities, social sciences, ethic and law, all these things are also taught to mechanical engineers. So I have overall given you an idea about what are the different kind of courses, core courses and electives that are typically offered to you. So there are certain courses that are offered by your own department, and then there are certain courses that are offered to you by other departments that you can take up to increase your knowledge or increase the domain in which you want to really work in the future. So the other important thing is that once you are really done with your graduation in mechanical engineering, so now you will be looking for a job. And to get a job, one of the most important things these days, which everyone is talking about, our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi is talking about, are the skill sets that are required. So down the line, if I talk about 10 to 15 years back, so there were only 4 to 5 skills that were really important to get employed, which were communication skills, honesty, interpersonal, strong work ethics, teamwork skills, and analytical skills. But if we really talk about in 2016, the scenario has totally changed. It is not these 5 skills that are important. There are certain set of skills, maybe 15-20 skills that the organization which wants to hire you is looking for. So to give you some key idea about, is leadership is very key skill that the organization which wants to hire you is looking into. Then ability to work with a team, communication skills, problem solving skills. So these skills which I'm speaking to you are actually highly rated skills. I mean 80%, 79%, 70%, this is the weightage which any organization which wants to really hire you is looking into you. If I really talk about the technical skills, so technical skills is roughly around 55 to 60% range. So yeah, technical knowledge is important, but apart from that, strong work ethics, communication skills, problem solving skills, these skills also become important. So during your graduation, you really need to brush yourself. You need to really develop all these traits in you, so that you can really get employed. And leadership and ability to take initiatives in any organization plays an important role, because when you really have leadership qualities, when you have initiative taking traits, then you can really contribute to an organization. Technical knowledge obviously is important, but these things are also there. Apart from these things, we have computer skills, we have detail oriented skills, then organizational ability, We have friendly attitude toward other people in the organization, strategic planning and skills. We have creativity, we have tactfulness, entrepreneurial skills. So these are certain skills that are really important to get employed in any organization these days. So what do really mechanical engineers do? If somebody would ask you, so do they build a bridge? Do they make a robot? Or do they fly a plane or make a plane, work on a computer, maybe work on a car engine or drive a train? So these are certain things that you might be thinking, what would you really do after doing your graduation in mechanical engineering? So basically, if you graduate in mechanical engineering, so there will be certain set of job descriptions that you can apply, or maybe once you join an organization, they will be giving you certain job titles. So they could be graduate engineer trainee, they could be graduate management trainee, depending upon you join in a management organization or you join in a technical area as an engineer. So then analytical engineer, if you join as a design engineer, so you'll be given a designation of design engineer. If you join in an organization where you're going to test stuff, then probably they'll be giving you the title of a test engineer. If you join in an organization which is into manufacturing, so probably you'll be having the title of manufacturing engineer, development engineer. Then if you're into a research organization or in an organization which your department is research, so you'd be given a title of research engineer. Then there are sales engineer, engineering manager. Probably if you are going on a post of a manager in an organization, and consulting engineers. So these are certain titles probably which you would be having when you'll be working as a engineer in any organization. But what are the different type of jobs that you're going to do? So this was about the title. Then after the titles, I'm going to talk about what are the different type of jobs you can do. So you can be a design engineer. So as a design, now design is a term which is lamely used at times, but when we really talk about design in terms of mechanical engineering, we talk about product design, maybe redesigning a thing, maybe redesigning a pen, maybe redesigning a mobile phone, it could be like that, maybe redesigning a vehicle as well. Machine design, specific to the components of a machine. Then we have system design, designing the whole organization, designing the whole machine itself. Then we have manufacturing sector. Manufacturing sector is in India particularly is dominated by automotive sector. Then we have process development and quality, maybe designing the whole new process of doing something and checking the quality of what is being produced in an organization, maintenance and operations. So wherever we have heavy machinery or equipment which needs maintenance and day-to-day operation, so particularly if I have to give an example, I would like to quote maintenance and operations, your thermal power plants. Then we have project management, where you have implementation of different machineries, or where you have installation of thermal power plants or heating, ventilation and air conditioning units. Then we have testing of the equipment, particularly if I talk about automotive testing, where we test engines, where we test vehicles, we test other components such as brakes, tires. Then we have sales or technical sales, where you would be working in corporate area, where you would be selling out products which are produced by industries which are purely mechanical in nature. Then obviously management, where your skills would be important. So then we have electric power generation, one of the very strong areas where mechanical engineers are required. Oil drilling, oil extraction, gas drilling, gas extraction. Now renewable energy is one of the upcoming areas where mechanical engineers are specially required. Particularly we have fuel cells, wind power, hydroelectric, nuclear, geothermal, wind power, biomass, hydrogen and solar. So some of the key areas where mechanical engineers are required. Then we have the analysis. So often we do face failures when we are talking about machinery. So failures do occur. So when we face failure, so we really need to inquire about them. So we have mechanical engineers who really see how a equipment is performing, how reliable it is. So we do carry out the failure analysis to improve the performance and reliability of the equipment. Then we have heat transfer, vibration, sound engineering, acoustics, so very important. Then we have the fabrication part. So mechanical engineers do coordinate in fabrication of equipment, particularly the shipbuilding, if I talk about, or maybe big equipments. Then we develop improved fabrication techniques and method. Then we have tests, so we can perform different type of tests. They can be performance tests, They can be reliability test, confirmation of productivity test. Then we have equipment process and test. I mean, there are different set of tests depending upon what area it is, or depending upon what are the different. So then we have research and development. So research and development also plays a very important role. A lot of mechanical engineers are employed in automotive sector and, you know, energy sector for research and development. Then we have marketing and sales, very important area. So mechanical engineers are also employed by marketing sector, particularly where they are dealing with technical products, where they are dealing with machinery. So that they can keep plants, process operations at optimum performance, particularly for maintenance and operations. So as I've earlier talked about, operation supervision and management is also essential area where mechanical engineers are required. Then we do have management where mechanical engineers are employed. Then others, particularly if I talk about law and business schools as well. Now a lot of mechanical engineers do take up intellectual property area where they can, you know, practice, and they can, you know, be property, intellectual property right consultants also. So they are taking up. And we do have business schools where they have, you know, management courses. They do take up management as a career, and then they, you know, go there. So what do we talk when we really talk about that? All this. So we have not really talked about what money do you get. So once you've completed your graduation, there are different packages that you can get. Now when we really talk about the money part, so money will play a very important and a very crucial role. So in general, in the Indian sector, if I talk about the money, so you can get from money ranging from starting from 3.3 to 3.5 lakhs to roughly up around say 15 lakhs, maybe 20 lakhs, it depends upon you. So also there is a very high economic return for an engineering degree, even if graduate works in a non-engineering field. So it is not like that you have to go in poor area. At times people find lower pay packages in poor areas. So even if you really shift towards non-poor areas, you still have a higher economic return in terms of what you've really, you know, invested in getting a degree. So that is there. So it is quite promising even if you don't really go in poor area and you shift on to a area which is non-core. Okay. So now we come and we really talk about what are the promising industries for mechanical engineers. To start with, one of the most important sectors is the government sector. So in government sector, we do have a lot of jobs available. We have public sector unit, we have oil industry, we have oil and gas industry, we have Gas Authority of India Limited, then we have Indian Oil Corporation. I mean, I can name a lot of organizations like that. And then we have NATRIP, which is specific to automotive sector. Then we have Indian Engineering Services, which is very promising for mechanical engineers. That is core area. We have Indian Railway Services. Railway happens to be the biggest employer in the world. So they have roughly over 1 million employees. So one of the very promising sector. So then we do have other mechanical engineering jobs in state governments, such as assistant engineer to start with, or sometimes executive engineer jobs, which are available in the government sector. So the first priority is generally given to the government sector in any case, particularly with the Indian context. Now, when we talk about the private sector, we do have the energy sector. So I would like to give you a figure over here. India is the fifth economy in terms of renewable energy. And India happens to be a 65 billion economy if I really talk about the renewable energy sector. In general, the oil and gas sector is big sector, but if oil and gas sector provides one job, then renewable energy sector is providing four jobs. So the ratio is 1:4. So that is quite promising. So renewable energy is the most upcoming sector. Now, I really put them in an order so that in terms of their importance. So the first importance I'm giving is to the renewable energy sector, seeing the growth in the sector, seeing the focus of government in this sector. Then I would like to talk about entrepreneurship and startups. Now government is also pushing a lot of startups and entrepreneurship so that you become an employer rather than an employer. So you can, after doing your graduation, because of the versatile nature of mechanical engineering, you can obviously take up innovation and you can start up your own area, maybe develop a product, maybe develop a service. So that is one thing which I would like to, you know, after energy sector, I would like to highlight that. So being an entrepreneur or, you know, having your own startup, then we do have manufacturing industry. Now, manufacturing industry is dominated by mechanical engineers totally. So I think around 25% engineers who, you know, graduate typically join manufacturing sector. It has huge potential. It usually contributes to the GDP of the nation. So that is there. Then we have automation and robotics. Now, particularly with regard to manufacturing sector, a lot of automation and robotics is coming up. That is making the system a bit complex, but it is making it cost efficient also. However, the initial cost investment is a bit high in automation and robotics, but overall, the cost comes down after a certain period of time. So that is there. So automation and robotics is also coming up in a big way. Now, we are talking about Industry 4.0, where we are, you know, talking about total automation of the industry from ordering a product to delivering a product. So that is there. So it has huge potential. Then the automotive sector. Now, automotive sector, if I talk about 10 years back, was the sunrise. It was called the sunrise sector of India. Contribution to the GDP, national GDP, was almost 17%. So that was there. However, there has been certain slowdown, and obviously due to the climate change and pollution, there's a change in the there are a lot of transformation in the sector. Now, this is I see this as an opportunity rather than the slowing down of the sector, because it will take a while for the sector, automotive sector, to settle down. However, this will be promising in the future. It will definitely grow in the future. So then we have supply chain and logistics. As you already are well acquainted, you might be ordering stuff from Amazon, Flipkart and other e-portals. So supply chain, logistics and, you know, warehouse are playing a big role, and this happens to be an area called as materials management, which again comes under mechanical engineering, industrial engineering. Industrial engineering is a sub-branch of mechanical engineering. So it is playing huge role. It has huge potential. There are specific, in fact, I'll say that there are specific courses in masters which offer supply chain management courses. So very promising area. A lot of people are opting it as a long-term career, and in the future logistics and supply chain is going to grow. So it will definitely really help you in shaping your career. A very promising area. Then we have materials area. Now, materials area is one area where mechanical engineers are taking a lead, specifically if I talk about nanotechnology. So nanotechnology is coming up in a big way. Now, the scope of nanotechnology is seen in machinery, it is seen in bio areas, it is seen in producing stronger materials, composites, lightweight materials, which are essential in automotive sector or some other sectors which are there. So nanotechnology is coming up in a big way, and American Society for Mechanical Engineers specifically sees the next 20 years dedicated to nanotechnology for building up infrastructure, for increasing the scope of nanotechnology for implementation in the industry. So nanotechnology also happens to be a promising area, materials, from the materials perspective. So however, you'll find physicists also working in this area, but mechanical engineers do dominate this area in the industry. Then we have power generation. Now, power generation has always been the thrust area in mechanical engineering. Either be it thermal power plant, either be it, you talk about, you know, wind energy, or you really talk about hydroelectric. So mechanical engineers has always dominated this area. So core mechanical engineering branch, and Government of India is also coming up with a lot of projects specifically for power generation, their installation, either be it nuclear energy. So all these energies are, you know, power generation are totally dominated by mechanical engineer. So this will be a very promising career in terms of future. Apart from power generation, there is a thing called as cogeneration. Now, cogeneration is when we have combined heat and power, so you need both power and you do need hot water or steam for some process. So that is also totally dominated by mechanical engineers. Then I'd like to talk about bioengineering and biomedical industry. So bio word is going to be a buzzword for next maybe 500 years. and mechanical engineers are really contributing to that in in a serious way. There are different courses that are being offered at graduate level, particularly biomechanics course, where you can really try to develop artificial human parts which can replace the affected people if differently abled people. So that is there. And biomedical industry, particularly the equipment which is being produced for use in hospitals or CT scans, maybe ultrasound, all these are being produced by mechanical engineers. So huge lot of potential is there in bioengineering and biomedical industry. Then we have aerospace industry. Now aerospace industry is also going through a transformation. We are talking about drone taxis and different electric based taxis and other stuff. And if I talk about US, so in US they are already planning to launch some services related to that. But over a long time, the aerospace industry has grown a while, and India is also promoting Make in India. Yeah. So that is going to really play a major role. So aerospace industry is going to grow in India also. So you can really take a career in aerospace industry as well, being a mechanical engineer. So from the mechanical engineer perspective, there are two things which are really essential. One is the construction of the plane itself, and then the other part is the manufacturing, the maintenance and operation of the engine that is there, that is being used in the aerospace industry. So mechanical engineers play a major role in these specific areas in aerospace industry. Then we have the defense sector. As government of India is spending a lot of money, and a lot of money is going abroad because we really need to buy a lot of equipment from foreign countries. So government of India is promoting specifically a defense sector in which FDI, foreign direct investment, is being seen. So in India, it is going to grow in a big way. The automotive defense sector, a lot of companies are going to come up, and they are going to set up their houses, manufacturing houses and facilities here in India. So defense sector is going to be promising, either be it planes, either be it ships, either be it guns. So all these things will definitely, production will definitely require mechanical engineers for maybe marketing, for other things. And then we have, lastly, I would like to talk about shipping industry and marine industry. So shipping industry has always been dominated by mechanical engineers. The reason being is shipping is a core mechanical industry. So we have logistics involved there, and then we have diesel engines, compressed natural gas engines, and the propellers that are being driven. All that is totally mechanical. So mechanical engineers are employed there on the ships, in the shipyards, everywhere, ship building, ship construction, marine industry, either be it yachts, either be it big, ferries. So that is there. So these are all the promising areas which mechanical engineering offers, which I doubt any other stream offers in career growth, and the potential that mechanical engineering has in terms of versatility, in terms of application part, any other field or any other area would promise you. So that'll be all for the lecture, and I'm open to the questions that you can ask me. So I have this question that why mechanical engineering is so versatile. So it is versatile because we have a lot of courses which are there. For example, if I talk about different courses, so we have, say for example, we have machine design, right? And then we have mechatronics, in which you are studying about electronics also, where you are sandwiching both electronics and mechanical systems. So that is there. Then if you really talk about sensor, now sensor happens to be electronics area, but where do you find the application part? So application is always there in mechanical engineering. So all the machineries, all the automotive vehicles that you drive to day to day, all use sensors. So the application part will always be there in mechanical engineering. Thank you.